Hey, what's going on, everyone? It's Green Zero here bringing you another Command & Conquer 3 Kane's Wrath video commentary. We are back with the Kane's Wrath World Championships 2014. We have preliminary final B here today. That's right, preliminary final B. We're down at the top four. If you haven't seen the other VODs, check them out before you watch this one. Obviously, you can tell by the description on the video and the score screen here, or the player status screen. We have Master Leaf and Bike Rush Owns. These guys faced off in the group series and Bike Rush defeated Master Leaf 2-0. But of course, we have two strike rules in effect. It's a best of seven, that's right. Best of seven, loser goes to third place, and the winner goes to the grand final for a shot at $700. Myself and Cybert dual casted this one live. I suggest you go and watch the stream, because to be honest, having me and Cybert there with live and all the atmosphere, it was way better. It's one of the best series of the tournament so far, I think, in the terms of how the games went down, the clutchness of the games, the endings, and oh my God. It was just crazy, and I couldn't believe it, but we are casting every single match in the tournament, which includes this one, so I'll be casting them all again. Again, I know what happens, but I'll be commentating under the assumption that I'm not going to be giving away anything, and we're going to make it as good as possible. So again, check out the stream, because that was live, myself and Cybert, crazy stuff, but we're going to jump into this one now. It's going to be Master Leaf and Bike Rush Owns. We are on Undergrounds, and looks like Leaf actually selected. This is interesting. He went Reaper 17 now. It's the first game, so there's no strike rule. There's nothing like that. In effect, he actually decided, no, I'm going to play Reaper 17. And he's on the right-hand side. And we have Bike Rush playing as Blackhand, obviously. What other faction was he going to play? So he's going to be starting out with a few Cabal squads. Really, there's not much Leaf can do to stop him from taking both the spikes on this map. He has got one engineer. He's going for a second engineer, so just the two engineer cells off the hand of Nod there, and he's going to be making his way out. I don't think almost called him Unleashed. Geez, when he's purple, he definitely looks a little bit unlike Unleashed, doesn't he? But he's Reaper, and did he even send any scouts out? Master Leaf, wow. Living life on the edge, Master Leaf. He's against Blackhand, which means he is going to have to scout, you know, otherwise his risk of being rushed is just crazy. He's going to get a buzzer from the draft there, but again, he's really keeping his options tight in terms of cost, because he hasn't spent a lot of money on buzzers. Normally you'd spend, you know, $800 on buzzers, maybe even $1,000 on buzzers if you're selling on too many hives or things like that. Takes the building so he can't get dug up, and he's going to take this spike again. He went ref first before taking that, so it's going to put him a little bit ahead. Shardwalker first out of the gate, so again, that's what Leaf's strategy was. It was to build a Shardwalker. He should have cleaned up that squad, but he didn't have time for that. He ain't got no time for that Cabal squad, and he's just going to go straight up. And again, this is the thing. What he did, he went ref first, then barracks, and it's to build this Shardwalker to go scout bike. And Bike Rush is over here now. He's got an Operation Center down, which means there is a Flame Rush coming out, and a Flame Tank is there. And Bike Rush is aware there is a Shardwalker that's coming to scout him. He's actually pulling this back. That's interesting here. As we can see, Master Leaf is not going to be able to see this Flame Tank. He's moving back, and I think once he gets to, let's have a look here, second Flame Tank coming out, but oh, he's going to turn around. He spots the upgraded power plant, so he knows that, and he can see the Black Ant Squad and the Flame Tank. But again, he probably thinks that's the one and only Flame Tank, where really Bike Rush has one back here. It is actually moving back into the vision, so again, just, I think it might have wandered into Leaf's vision, but whether or not he noticed it, that's to be seen. He does crush off the Black Hand, which is nice, and a double wall factory, and Bike Rush sells his MCV. He sells his MCV all in with Flame. How's Master Leaf going to counter this? He's got one Seeker Tank out, two Seeker Tanks out, and the Flame Tank is forced all the way back. Bike's coming out now. He will kill these Cabal squads. He's actually trying to go for the engineer, but he's not going to be able to get it, so unfortunately losing the scout. But Leaf has got the read that he needs. He knows there's Flame out. He knows it's double War Factory all in. But can he hold this off now? This is probably one of the reasons why he went for Reaper, because they have Shielded Harvesters. He's actually got a Dev Tank out already, and that's serious problems for Bike, because that's going to one-shot. Basically, these Bikes one-shot death. The Flame Tank can only take a couple of hits from a Dev Tank. And he's got a second Dev Tank out now, and he's going to be going to charge that up. There's a few Seeker Tanks, but they're sitting behind the War Factory. He must be aware there's no Reckoner out here, because he killed off the Black Hand Squad. He's actually moving around searching for the potential Flame Tank. One of them is moving up here towards the spike, but the other one remains to be seen. We know he has got two on the map somewhere, and Leaf probably wondering where this attack is. He's not getting pushed, and I mean, ultimately, he saw the MCV cell. He should just sit around at least for, you know, 2, maybe 3 minutes if he's not getting attacked, just to stay here, because he knows his opponent isn't building any economy, so he can just defend and he'll always have the eco advantage. And again, using up some beam on the infantry, not really what you want to do. Does lose a spike, That flame tank going to be backing out here. And again, Shielded Harvesters, Dev Tanks, and now Shardwalkers here. Bike Rush is in a little bit of trouble, should I say, because he's not doing any economic damage. Meanwhile, he's actually building Scoring Tanks. He's got Harvesters queued up. He's got too many Harvesters, which is pretty bad. Cabala Squad still coming in again. Not sure what's happening. There are some bikes moving to the back here. They might actually snipe a Seeker Tank down. No, they're not quite going to get that Seeker Tank. These units moving forward. Now the Shard Launcher. Oh no, there's actually a Flame Tank there. He sees that the Seeker Tanks are going to give chase. Something's happening back there. Bikes getting scared away by Seeker Tanks. And can he actually kill this Flame Tank? I think Bike Rush might have had to just push it forward, because I think these Seeker Tanks are going to chase it down. Meanwhile, Masterly Space is pretty safe at the moment. And yeah, once he gets it on heavy damage mode, that's going to be it. He's getting flamed down, and that's not good. The Napalm actually does quite a bit of damage, but it doesn't matter. He does overwhelm those forces here. Battle Marker's coming down there. Dev Tank gets sniped. Couple of bikes get picked off in the process. Not sure if it's worth it for either player here. Another bike probably going to go down, and these bikes are stuck now between these Seeker Tanks and the ones behind them. But there are a lot of Scorpion Tanks here. We have 8 Scorpion Tanks, and of course, Scorpion Tank's just naturally better than Seeker Tanks in this kind of situation. He's going to be pulling back. There is one Devourer Tank here. Needs to be reverse moving. And there we go. They just automatically do it because they can't rotate their turret. Flame Tank in the back gets the tech center. However, there is one Mechapede out. Elite's Flame Tank goes down. This Dev Tank might want to back up. He has caused a lot of damage, though, and putting a lot of pain on. But here's the thing. He's bringing out Double Portal and Disintegrator Squads. Bike Rush has no answer to those. And really, a panic weapon or a panic type weapon for Reaper 17. No upgrades, no fast legs or anything like that. But of course, the Scorpion Tanks either have to crush them and explode. Oh, the Mechapede does go down though. So that was his only tech unit. And that really would have come in handy for Leaf, just to have at least one of them there, because he can use it with the reverse move type to kill things. But the Scorpion Tanks managed to focus the head down. Cannon damage, obviously, a little bit of a weakness for those Mechapedes if you can get the head. Otherwise, it's just a nightmare. And these Scorpion Tanks moving around now, but really, they've got nothing to stop these Disintegrator Squads. And now they're stuck between Disintegrator Squads on both sides, and he is going to get rid of that Seeker Tank. But again, more Scorpion Tanks going down, and another Harvester. Oh my god, why did I call it a Harvester? Another Scorpion Tank going down. He needs to clean some of these buggies up. Again, Bike Rush, these buggies are faster than the Disintegrators, but he goes straight through those guys. And Leaf getting some nice good kills here. That's good for him. I mean, destroying units with just Disintegrator Squads is perfectly fine for Master Leaf, I think, because these really aren't that expensive for Leaf to produce, and the DPS is quite high. A few Dev Tanks coming in here now. Looks like they might try to snipe down this one Dev Tank. Sorry, the bike's coming in to snipe their tank. They will actually get one. Maybe. Oh, no, not quite. Does not quite get it, but he's going to get it now. Oh, that buggy just goes straight to Elite as well because of that kill. And now another Dev Tank. It isn't charged up, though, so he might want to focus down some of these Dev Tanks. He's going to lose it. Some of these Scorpion Tanks. He does lose a Dev Tank, but these Scorpion Tanks are as good as dead, and there's not much he can do against the remainder of the Dev Tanks. And there are Disintegrator Squads here, and Bike Rush is getting cleaned up. Again, just hasn't got any Harvesters. He's trading units for units, and at the end of the day, that's not going to win you an all-in rush, because your opponent has superior economy. They can just keep replacing those beyond the use of their first field. 3 Dev Tanks here, none of them are charged up. And again, Bike Rush moving to the expansion. Sees there's nothing there. These are only buggies, so they're not really going to do a lot. We got the Ravager Squad still from the tech center. They got destroyed. Could use Tiberium Agitation if he ran around and attacked a Harvester. Can't imagine he would have done much damage at all, because he's just one little Ravager there. It's interesting that they do get blue shards for Reaper 17. No speed upgrades, so again, they're not very good. The only faction that would ever build them is really going to be Traveler 59, but they just have better options. Again, the Ravager, just a little bit too expensive and a little bit too flimsy. But again, they are the fastest infantry unit in the game. They literally fly along the ground. Not sure if anyone's seen that when they have advanced articulators. Crazy fast. I think they need a bit more armor. But Lightning Spike here are going to be defending these Harvesters. These Harvesters are going to move off the field, but Leaf sells up his nerve center. He's like, all right, I can't defend that. And he quickly sells it up. Might as well get money for it. These Disintegrator Squads probably aren't going to last very long against these buggies. Probably should stop building them. Yeah, he sells the portal. He has got 2 Dev Tanks down here, fully charged, mind you. And Bike Rush is destroying what he can, which is power plants, upgraded power plants, which is ultimately going to cost Leaf quite a bit, and a few bikes going down now. But these Dev Tanks need to turn around and get back up to this fight. What's happening down there? We got a Buzzer Swarm scouting out. You can see there's still no MCV here, and it's probably nothing in expansion. But, oh geez, it's a bit of a gap here. There's a lot of bike buggy. There's only one Dev Tank to defend, and he gets 2 bikes. But 2 bikes for a Dev Tank, definitely not worth it. And Bike Rush can be happy. These Harvesters now are up for grabs. There's 5 Harvesters here. Master Leaf drops a Buzzer Hive. It needed to be a Photon Cannon. Shardwalkers are trying to focus these guys down. Here come the 2 Dev Tanks, which you really need a little bit sooner. But again, 1 Harvester down, 2 Harvester, 3 Harvesters are now down. Yep, now down. He lost 3 Harvesters. If he gets another one, it's going to be crazy. One of the Dev Tanks gets sniped straight away. The other Dev Tank is being focused down, but the DPS here is just cracking Bike Rush's forces. and Bycrush ultimately won't be able to hang around here, but Leaf has been reduced to just two harvesters, and that was crazy bad, losing three harvesters in that attack, and another harvester does come out, but he doesn't have access to dev tanks anymore, which means he's probably going to have to rely on Seeker tanks, and this might be the point where he needs to put down a portal and get those gravity stabilizers. Sorry, not the gravity stabilizers. Well, geez, I'm very tired. get the photon cannons down. More Bike Bucky moving in now, and Leaf, oh no, harvesters are stacking momentarily there, and I think he may lose his harvesters here. And Bycrush is still all in. Mind you, he has been taking blue tip. He does have access to three spike, if you haven't noticed that as well. Bycrush rolling on three spike, and he's going to get another harvester, trying to get repairs around the war factory. The Shardwalkers are focusing these bikes down, but he just manages to get it there. Just managed to get it. Most of the bikes have been cleaned up. There's only one harvester remaining here from Leaf, and a second harvester now coming out. So having to rebuild these harvesters just means less units for Leaf to defend with. That Shardwalker is going in the wrong direction. He needs to turn that one around right now, and he is going to. But Bycrush is still pushing Bike Buggy, and he's just keeping Leaf penned in. And Leaf, his economy is actually smaller than what Bycrush is. Bycrush has three harvesters. I imagine he's still trying to... Yeah, he's still taking blue tip. It's actually all gone. So he's actually managed to harvest all the blue tip. And now focusing down more harvesters here. The Shardwalkers are trying to focus down the bikes. And again, if there's enough of them, which he does have four, they can focus the bikes down quite well. Another harvester falls here, and it's going to be bikes versus these Shardwalkers here, blowing up the tip as well. And yeah, Leaf just doesn't have enough. These Shardwalkers are going to go down, and I think Master Leaf is going to be dropping this first game, and Master Leaf is down and out. That is game one of this series, and far out. Leaf, I mean, he looked good. He was in a good, strong position. He even had time to go for his tech center, but Bycrush was just relentless, and I think those two dev tanks getting caught out of position, I would have said it in the stream as well, but nonetheless, Bycrush getting more money than Master Leaf. So there you go, the blue tib really impacting that game there, because Leaf was ahead the whole time, but blue tib of course pushed Bycrush off the edge, and Master Leaf just underestimated it. He just didn't realize how powerful it was going to get. He wasn't overcompensating any point in that game there, but the point where he started dropping harvesters, that's where Bycrush took hold of him, and that's where he won the game. And you can see there, we have the favorite unit, Attack Bike, and Disintegrator as per Bycrush and Master Leaf, respectively. 1.9 kill death ratio to 0.48. So, again, Master Leaf having the superior kill death ratio, but 53,000 to 59,000. Very close 10-minute game. That's game number one. So, Bycrush takes a 1-0 lead in this series, gets off the mark straight away. We're going to find out what happens in this series. Stay tuned. We have game two coming up right now. All right, welcome back, guys. It's Green Zero here casting the preliminary finals B from the Cane's Wrath World Championship. We are in game number two now. And again, let's keep it short, sharp, and snappy, because we're going to jump into this game. Bycrush Jones is playing a Skryn against Master Leaf's Traveler 59. So here you go. Master Leaf using the strike rule straight away, and Bycrush showing no fear, goes straight for Skryn. Of course, this is going to be Master Leaf playing as Orange. Yes, he's Orange Traveler 59. And Bycrush, if we whip over here, he's going to be playing as the red Skryn. Loves to play as the red color. And this is interesting, Skryn versus Traveler. I mean, Leaf is probably going to be very happy with this, because, you know, they have reasonably similar units. I mean, yeah, Skryn have a few heavier units than Traveler, obviously. They have dev tanks, they have better tripods, things like that. But they have shields as well, a lot of shields. But he has mind control, and he'll be looking forward to mind controlling the enemy Skryn units. And of course, we all know how desperate the Prodigy and Mastermind Wars get, because it's really hard for Skryn to take out other commando units, you know. They've only got the buzzer support power. Everything else is slower than that infantry unit, so they really need to get into position. Aside from Mechapedes, I guess. But again, if you got lots of Mechapedes out, people don't really build commando units, because the mechas will snipe them too easily, or they'll just sit in their base. But Bycrush sees, he sees the fast legs. Bycrush does not have any fast legs out. He took his spike nicely, and he's going to be defending at home. Now, obviously, he saw it well in advance. He's going to chase down this Buzzer Swarm, because why the hell not? He might as well do as much damage. Bycrush cooling back some of the Buzzer Swarms to his base, forces out a Gunwalker, forces out a Buzzer Hive, but this really is not going to do... Oh, forces out a second Buzzer Hive, but that's not going to do much at all. And Master Leaf actually gets away pretty much scot-free. Took a tiny bit of damage there, a little bit of damage there. He's going to kill that Buzzer Swarm there. But again, if nothing else, he has forced out the defenses there from Bycrush. Second Harvester just pops out now. Master Leaf only slightly behind that retrospect, maybe about 5 seconds behind. But of course, he does have these Disintegrators. And as you can see there, he's going to make his way over to the spike and just be like, well, I can just blow your spike up now and just deny you that economy. So again, all Bycrush trying to dance around a little bit here. Not sure if he knows what he's doing. He is going to attack these guys. He'll have to go around the fences as well. And he does kill the Buzzer Swarm. So he's killed it. And now he's going to be able to chase the Gunwalker. Gunwalker kind of firing backwards. But let's see if Leaf can kill it. He does. He kills it. And that's big, because Bycrush actually has a Corruptor. And that's going to be the saving grace. Without the Corruptor, he'd be in pretty big trouble. Again, the reactor would probably fall pretty quickly. And again, Leaf just trying to find an entrance and just managing to stay out of range of that corrupt. Look at his little legs trying to run and keep up with these disintegrators, but they're just too quick. He's getting close, I can tell you that right now. He's getting very close, but he's not going to be able to get in range. Battle marker down there. It's just a scouting squad. And look at that. Master Leaf almost caught him unleashed again. Oh, these screen guys, they all look the same. But he's got a nerve center. And what is he doing? He is going for another structural. It's not a ref. He's only one ref in it. So the disintegrator squads have actually circled back now. So this is interesting indeed. And he's going to move forward on these dev tanks, forcing them to waste their charge. He might get a kill. No, he's just going to back off. He's like, all right, no worries. I'll just pull back from those guys there. And Bike Rush is moving his drone platform across the entire map. It's actually called a drone ship when it's in the air, and a drone platform when it's on the ground. And I think Leaf is aware of it, calling the buzzer swarm, and nothing comes out. He powers it down. Nice power micro there from Leaf. He's probably got cultists coming. Actually, good, they got killed. Sorry, no, they're dead. They died on the way out. And again, he's putting it out. Sells off the warp sphere. Knows he's not going to need it anymore because his vehicles are inferior. There you go, drone platform. Because his vehicles are inferior. He's going to get a cultist squad out now. If he can take the dev tanks, he'll be sitting pretty, but Bike Rush is going to be spamming these buzzer hives now. And that's the point where you don't want to be there. And disintegrator swords come out. He's going to be able to destroy this buzzer hive pretty quickly. Again, having this corruptor here is all the help in the world. And he's got another portal over here as well. So he's got two cultist squads, and he needs to make sure he micros these very well. Buzzer hive comes down again. It's Bike Crash's buzzer hive, and he's going to go forward. Is he going to get the dev tanks? He gets one dev tank, and he's going to lose. He loses the corruptors, not the corruptor. He loses the cultists, but he manages to get it back. And now these guys are firing at each other. The corruptors versus corruptors, and the dev tank versus dev tank. And yeah, he snipes down the enemy dev tank, and he'll probably get the corruptor as well. And Bike Crash is in a little bit of trouble here, and mind controls the corruptor as well. Oh man, this is not turning out very well. And this is really why you do not do this in the screen mirror, because Traveler 59 can just take all your attacking units. And yeah, you've got buzzer hives on the front line. Yeah, you've got buzzer hives there, but really, I mean, these guys are so fast, especially with advanced articulators, especially when Leaf opened with advanced articulators. He doesn't need that upgrade again, and he's trying to focus down the drone platform, forcing Bike Crash to sell off the portal. It's getting very messy. You can hardly tell what's going on here. He's trying to get a portal down to capture the drone ship, but I don't think it's going to happen. Master Leaf losing units here. Buzzers versus buzzers, and I think the drone ship may fall. This Devourer tank isn't going to fall. There's another spare Coldest squad back here while these two units are mind controlled, and Disintegrator squad's coming now, I think. Oh no, he's going to take off. He's going to try to take off. And yes, Leaf kills the drone platform. He kills it. He kills it before it can leave the ground, because of course, when it tries to lift off, it gets its low damage mode, and Assimilator gets taken out. And oh, that's going to be the end of it for Bike Rush here. He can't possibly win from here. And that is why you do not rush that. I think Bike Rush is a little bit overconfident. And Master Leaf, that is very, very messy gameplay from both sides, but they're forced into it. They're forced into these like mass buzzer, cultist, micro, Assimilator kind of things. And it's very messy. 5 minute game there. And Master Leaf has drawn it level. Well done there from Leaf to draw this game level. I know a lot of people in the stream were very heavily barracking for him, including myself here. But, you know, Bike Rush there, he's a very powerful player. You're expecting him to do very well in the tournament. And we'll try to keep it on level terms here. But buzzer favorite unit for Bike Rush, which is interesting. Disintegrator for Master Leaf, obviously. Master Leaf got 19,000, Bike Rush got 15,000. Again, he lost his spike early on, so there's a $4,000 difference there. Or not even 4,000, probably about 3,300. And that's going to be a nice win for Master Leaf, leveling the series in a 5 minute game. So another reasonably quick one here. Bike Rush technically didn't all in rush, he drone ship push, which, you know, usually ends in the game ending pretty quickly because one player will kill the other pretty quick. But nonetheless, that was game number two. It is 1-1 in this preliminary finals, best of seven series. So we're going to be going on to the next game now. Stay tuned, it's coming right up. All right, what's going on, everyone? It's Green Zero back here with game number three from the preliminary finals, number B. Between Master Leaf and Bike Rush owns, it is 1-1 in this series. And oh man, you can feel the tension. You can feel the tension, especially in the stream here. And of course, reminding you once again that Cyber and myself did live cast, and that's why we're observers here, but I'll be casting all the games from the tournament as well as the other guys to bring you a full replay pack as well as a full VOD pack. And this is game number three. It's going to be Black Hand versus Traveler 59. So Bike Rush getting the opportunity to strike, and he didn't use it. So again, he's going to have to use those at some point in time because it's to his advantage, but he's picked Black Hand. This is going to be Leaf in the top corner, at the top center, sorry. And he's going to be against Bike Rush in the bottom center. We are on Smash Dust Bowl now. Remember, they can't play Tournament Dust Bowl because you can't play a Smashed and Original at the same time or in the same series because basically the maps are the same. Doesn't apply to Rift though because it's significantly different from Twisted Rift. So that's just fine and dandy. But he drafted quite a lot of Cabals, didn't he? That's quite a lot considering he's only going for one of the spikes. I mean, he's against Traveler 59, but seriously, he could definitely take out any buzzers. That's fine. He could get both of those spikes for sure. But let's see what Leaf is doing now. He's doing this strategy again here where he builds disintegrators regardless of the faction he's playing against. It just gives you just great map control. And again, force frying the ground so it groups these guys together. I think I mentioned that in one of the tech games as well. And he's going to be moving out straight down the guts. Of course, there's no buildings to block him or anything like that. But Blycrush is probably going to see this well in advance. And he does this where he just evolves to the wall, just goes straight down the line. And he's going to get shot up here. Blycrush is coming in. He's putting some damage on. Oh, man, it's flanks from both sides. And Leaf is going to lose two full squads and takes a tiny bit of damage on another one. So he's left with just four squads. And Blycrush has a lot of... he's got a lot of units out there, but he's only got one harvester as well. And these disintegrators are just running straight in to get the harvester. And if he gets the harvester, that's it. That's just about... Oh, he gets it, but the flame unit comes out. The flame cell is down. And of course... Once you have a Black Hand squad, that's goodbye to disintegrators. They will die instantly, basically. But Blycrush has no harvesters, pumping out a harvester now, so he's on one harvester. But I can't imagine that Master Leaf has two harvesters. Yes, he does have two harvesters. He's not going for another refinery. He's going to go for a third harvester, because when you do something like this, it's usually better just to get the third harvester first. It's quicker to get the third harvester, and it costs less. But Black Hand squad is making their way across the map. And Blycrush just sold his MCV, and there is another operations center down here. That's right, I've watched the stream, I know what happened. But he's got a Reckoner coming out, so Reckoner is rushing across the Tib field. I would have thought, again, in the stream, I would have thought he would have picked up the Engineer to take him to a Tib spike. But nonetheless, he's going to drive the Reckoner straight down the guts. He picked up the Black Hand squad, so he's got a Black Hand squad. He could pick up this Cabal squad at the same time. Gunwalker just crushing all these guys here, that's perfectly fine. Killing those guys off. And here comes the Reckoner, and it's going to roll into this base. And Leaf, I don't think he has really anything to count. He's got a building queued. I'm not sure what it is. I think it's a portal. I think it might be a portal. And again, putting a bit of damage on the Reckoner, but it's only got one flame unit inside, so he has got the opportunity to try to stop this. You know, he's got fast lane disintegrates. He should use the Gunwalker to finish off the Cabal squad, I think, just to get rid of that one. Even gets a veteran Gunwalker there. And just one Seeker tank versus this this Reckoner. He has got an Engineer Assimilator there, and he's trying to get shot at, but he is still crushing these guys. He could save the Warps here, but he chooses not to. He's got the Assimilator there, and there's a Flame Tank rolling in now. He hasn't got rid of the Reckoner. There's a Flame Tank here, and really, what's he going to do? He's only got disintegrates to stop it, and he's just going to flame and barbecue these guys down and just destroying the balls. Leaf is out of money now. Leaf is out of money. He's got an Assimilator behind that refinery, but really, what can he do? He's forced to build disintegrators, and there's a second Flame Tank here now, and this game is going to be wrapped up very, very quickly. Such a quick game. Game number three. Probably the shortest game in the series, if not the tournament. That was crazy quick, and Blycrush just didn't even care that his flame rush was delayed 3 minutes 28 seconds, so we couldn't believe that on the stream either. Masterleaf just went down that, just did not see it come and got blindsided and taken out. Blycrush making it look easy there. And look at that, Masterleaf only got $7,800 and Blycrush only got $6,500. That's less than what they start with, you know. That's crazy. Basically, Blycrush did that whole game on $16,000 and Leaf did it about $17,000, $18,000. But 2.13 kill death ratio to Masterleaf, so he had a superior kill death ratio. But again, just lost his base. Can't stop those flame tanks once they're in the base. Like, he had no use to stop them at all. And Blycrush quickly 2-1s Masterleaf here. So game three is over in a heartbeat. Hope you guys didn't miss that. It was so fast. But not much to say about the game. Masterleaf rushed, did the damage, and then just didn't expect the swift and powerful counterattack, especially with those two flame tanks following up. If it was just the Reckoner, maybe it would have been fine. But those two flame tanks coming in, bam, that sealed it. So that's game number three for the tournament there. We're going to be heading on to game number four now. Masterleaf versus Blycrush in the preliminaries of the Canes Wrath World Championship. Game number four is coming right up. All right, what's going on, everyone? It's Green Zero here, back with game number four in the tournament here from the preliminary finals B between Masterleaf and Blycrush owners. You should know the drill by now. Come on, we don't need to sit here and talk about it. Let's jump straight into this game. We are on Twisted Rift, the Rift. That is Twisted, and we're going to go down here, and we're going to see Masterleaf versus Blycrush's Black Hand. Now, I'm not sure if Masterleaf decided to use a strike rule in this game. I can't actually remember, but I'm pretty sure he wouldn't have let Blycrush play Black Hand on this level. I mean, it's going to favor Blycrush a little bit, I'd imagine. Big open level, lots of room to move, but again, it'll probably benefit Masterleaf's Mechapedes if he can get that far. But Blycrush, playing against the Traveler, doesn't like playing against those Prodigy mecha type attacks, and he probably will do some kind of rush here, not giving anything away. He may choose to eco. We'll have to see what happens. He's going for his refinery now. Masterleaf is actually doing the same strategy again with the disintegrators, doing it so many times that I think maybe he's just thinking that Blycrush won't expect it still. But again, when you repeat the same strategy so many times, it does become perplexing. You know, you just expect them to do it then, and all of a sudden they stop doing it. But he has got his disintegrator squads here. So let's see what he can do with these now. He did it on Arena. He did it on the last map. He did it on this map. And if we look back onto game number one, did he do it on game number one? I believe... No, he didn't do it on game number one because he was Reaper 17. So that's not the case. Cabal's stepping on Tiberium. Never good for your health. Now, it's interesting because Bycrush has no scouts in the middle, so he's not going to actually see it coming. And these disintegrator squads are just going to run straight past. Straight past. They could take the Cabal squad out. Bycrush has probably realized something's up, and yeah, kills the Cabal squad with minimal fuss, takes a little bit of damage to one of his squads, but every member of the squad is still alive, and now he's going to have to draft some of these Shredder turrets here. Leaf just going straight past it. He needs to watch out. Oh, that's barbecue time. Like, oh, barbecue time. He can't go near the Black Hand squad, and they just kill the disintegrators, melt them, and Bycrush pulls and drags around, and Mask Leaf has been completely denied there, and even loses a decent amount of his disintegrators. I'm surprised he's actually escaped with so many. That is really fortunate there. He should have taken a lot more damage now. Obviously, Bycrush trying to do the Flame Rush has just been severely hampered now because it's obviously not going to work. But again, he can just do what he did in the last game and just keep putting another one down, which he just built a Reckoner. I'm not sure how... Yeah, there we go. He's got another one. And Master's like, all right, you just build another Flame unit. Obviously, you wouldn't have sold it off without having a Flame Tank or a Reckoner because... You know, you're not just selling it just for the Black Hand. He has got some scouts, and he's still stepping on Tiberium, which is bad for him. He has got a Nerve Center, though. I'm not sure what he's planning to do with that. It's interesting that he would build that. And, oh, that's right, the Disintegrator squad's get a clutch kill on the Reckoner. Bycrush does run into it, and he sells his Cognate off straight away. Did he have a second Warfare? Yes, he did, but the Reckoner moved down here. The Disintegrators come up and smashed in the rear armor before it could escape, and he managed to force the deploy on it. If you damage him too much, it forces them to deploy. And now the Black Hand squads are out and about. They're just running across the field. It's like, whoa, what do we do now, guys? They need to do something. Buzzerhive here trying to clean these guys up. Again, I'm not sure what Leaf is trying to do with this combination. He's building Corruptors, and I think he might be building Cultists as well, because it's really the only reason he'd build a Stasis Chamber. I don't think he's going. Yeah, he just sold it off. He just realized that was probably a waste of money, unless that was from the start of the end. Sells off his Warp Sphere as well, and he manages to kill the Cabal squad. So that's nice. He's got triple Portal. And he sells off the Nerve Center, so a little bit of wasted tech there. He didn't really do much with that at all. I mean, yeah, he's got the Corruptor. He could sneak it around the map, maybe focus down that power plant, because without that power plant, Bycrush will grind to a halt. It'll take him twice as long to build anything. And these Buzzers now getting cleaned up here. That last Buzzer squad takes his revenge, takes down the Cabal squad. But Bycrush still has these Black Hand units moving across the middle of the map, the actual Black Hand themselves. And they can be really powerful if they're combined with an attack. Buggy's coming out as well. Bycrush obviously sniffs it out. And Master Leaf, yes, that's right, there's an assimilator here. He sold his drone platform. Now, at this point in the game, we were like, oh no, Leaf is in big trouble. But the fact is, look how many disintegrator squads he's got. So we're like, all right, let's see how this attack goes. He's going to push forward now, Bycrush forcing the all-in. And it was super risky for Leaf to actually sell this, drone platform. But Corruptor's coming through now. The Corruptor will actually waste all these Black Hand squads. And you can see even the Black Hand squad is just like, nah, not going to happen. Bikes move into the main field here. And both these Harvesters are undefended. That's going to be the end of the Harvesters. And Bike Rush, and ew, he doesn't even attack those. He just decides to move his Disintegrator squads to the enemy base. Not even trying to defend there. He's got a lot of Disintegrator squads. He's moving on the base. Bike Rush just sold off his second War Factory here. And there are so many Disintegrator squads here. Look how many Disintegrator squads here. It doesn't matter that they're bunched up. There's no Shredder turrets, and he can't build Shredder turrets. He's moving through, and he's just focusing down these buggies. He's killing them so fast. Look how fast these buggies die instantly. And the Harvester goes for the crush. He kills it straight away. And he's moving through now. Gets the Cabal squad. He's going to get more buggies, and he's just milking these buggies down. And Master is going to come down to Micro because he's got no Harvesters. He's got no money. The bikes are trying to focus his base down, but there's just too many buildings here. He's moving back, and there's reinforcements here for Master. And this was clutch. He sells off the refinery, and now he's got one building left. And Master goes all in for the last building. Buggies rock up from the south here, but it's not going to be enough. And Bycrush goes down, and we lost our shit in that stream when that went down. Master Leaf, if he hadn't made the decisions he did at the end of that game, it was good night, Master Leaf. And he levels the series at 2 games apiece in another 5-minute game there. So Leaf turning around saying, hey, I got the Disintegrator squads. You can't all in rush me. 2.86 kill death ratio. Surprising with the amount of Disintegrators he had. He had a crazy good kill death ratio. And again, $12,000 or $13,000 from Leaf, $15,000 from Bike. So Bike got more money this time. But again, it was minimal. And selling his drone platform off that would have taken some courage from Leaf to do that and to get the counterattack in there. I'm not sure if he was just like, just screw it and just threw all in, you know, see what happens. Or whether he really thought that what the strategy that he was doing when he was doing it was actually going to turn out this good and just trip Bike up. Invite just wasn't prepared for. The Desunares was in that kind of mass where he had like 25 squads or something like that. It just insta-sniped anything they were near, and it was just crazy hard. He had no splash damage. You know, those buggies have to pick apart those squads inch by inch, and it just doesn't happen. So 5-minute game there, Leaf getting a clutch victory. Again, definitely recommend checking out the stream because it was so good. Myself and Cyber and everyone watching online, that was definitely the way to go. But Leaf draws the series 2-2. Can Vicrush finish him off, or is Leaf going to take it all the way? Again, it's a best of seven, so basically whoever wins the next two games, whoever gets the next two victories, will be going through to the grand final of the Canes Wrath World Championship. We have game 5 coming up for you guys right now. All right, what's going on, everyone? It's Green Zero back with game number 5. It is 2-2 in this preliminary finals, Canes Wrath World Championships 2014. Master Leaf versus Vicrush Owns. And again, look at the factions, Trav 59 versus Blackhand. Vicrush not choosing to use that strike rule again. So Leaf is free to play as Traveler 59, and to be honest, I don't think Bike cares. I think Bike doesn't mind that he's playing as Traveler 59 because Bike's rush strategies are just so powerful versus Traveler 59. But Leaf just turning around, gutsy MCV cell, and pulled a clutch victory there in that in game number 4 to level the series, and he's hanging in there. He's hanging in there, but Bike Rush, ridiculously powerful. A lot of people have quoted him as being unbeatable, and essentially in the tournament, he is unbeatable, and the fact that no opponent has defeated him in a series. Yeah, he's dropped games along the way, but still the only player in the tournament who has been undefeated. In fact, coming into the final series, I was actually the player with the most consistency, only having dropped 2 games in the whole tournament, where Bike had dropped 3. So there you go, the more you know. But well, he's got Cabal squads coming down here now. He only went for one of the spikes, so these Cabal squads are basically just peripherals. They're just going down here just to make sure there's nothing fancy going on, kill anything they can find. Master Leaf does have an assimilator, unguarded assimilator. He's like, hey, I'm going fast legs, I don't need to send any scouts at all. I'm going to beat Blackhand there any day of the week. He did actually stop. He needs to keep moving. He really does need to keep moving, actually. But he isn't doing so. And he's moving the Disintegrators. Bike Rush does actually catch a slither of this. He gets a slither of it, so he knows about it. And he turns his Cabal squads around. But unfortunately, that allows Master Leaf, who momentarily forgot about his Assimilator, to quickly go ahead and capture that. So that's going to be nice for him. He's going to get a spike. So he's going to be on 2 spike. He quickly kills. No, he doesn't. He just moves through. And Bike Rush sells up. And this is what I'm talking about. This is what I'm talking about. He just moves through the defenses. He doesn't care about them. But that Blackhand squad does so much damage. And this time, it's not going to work out. The Blackhand squad and the positioning again, just like game number 4. And Master Leaf gets denied there, but loses everything in the process. And really does nothing but pulls the Harvester off the line for a few seconds. He's going to slow the Flame Rush down, but really, it's up to Master Leaf now. He's got to be scratching and going like, well, what do I do now? He's got the Stasis Chamber. I don't think he sold it off, unless he did replace that there. I'm pretty sure he did. That doesn't have a portal, but he is going for what appears to be a Nerve Center here. So yes, I know he's going for a Nerve Center, but it doesn't matter. I could just switch screens and check anyway. But Cabal Squad's moving across the map. Here comes the Reckoner. It's got double flame in it, which is going to be really powerful. Of course, there's no flame tanks to worry about, so I'd imagine Leaf is just going for a... He needs to upgrade that power plant as well, because he's got no power. He's going for a single Cultist squad, and that's so he can mind control the Reckoner, because if you mind control the Reckoner, anything inside the Reckoner actually dies, so that's going to be bad news for Bike. He sends the Reckoner in, and he's like... He doesn't actually deploy it, because he realizes... Hang on a sec, and he needs to realize not to do that. He's actually going to be able to destroy the Stasis Chamber, but it doesn't matter anymore. Leaf could have just sold that off. I don't think he needs it anymore, but now there's Buzzer Hives here. The Cultist Squad is just moving around these buildings like, I don't even care. The Blackhand get chewed up on the Buzzer Hives, and they're all going to go down. Both the squads are destroyed. The Cultist Squad is still alive, so Leaf held her off with no damage at all, and now Bike Rush is left with just infantry here. He's got some units coming from his base. It's Bike Buggy, because he's all in again. That's right, he's all in double warfare. He doesn't want to deal with late game travel. We've got another rush game here, but again, it's a very intense and tight series, and as far as all in rushing goes, this series is just like, oh, look at that. He sells off his War Factory as well. Leaf sells off his War Factory. He plants down another portal, but these Cultist Squad are as good as dead now. This Reckoner, what can it do from here? It's got Cabals inside, which is really the only infantry type he's got left. But he's going to be up against Disintegrator squads. If he deploys that Cabal squad down here, these portals are going to be having a hard time. But again, he's just going to be destroying these guys here. The Harvesters are now under attack from Master Leaf. He's going to get one Harvester straight away. The Disintegrator squad is trying to defend it up here, but Buggies are streaming through now. And he's got this Reckoner just killing everything that's coming outside the portals. And Master Leaf is in a little bit of trouble. He doesn't have too much to defend this off. He's got these Disintegrator squads. They need to try to focus these guys down. He's going to get this Buggy here, that's for sure. But I think there's a few too many Buggies here. He's trying to focus down the portals as well, because... Whoa, he has sold off his drone platform. He pushes those Buggies away, but that portal is going to go down, which leaves him with just one portal. Unfortunately, the Cabal squad here starts targeting the Buzzer Hive, which is exactly what Master Leaf wants to happen, and he actually kills it. So that's nice work there. He is totally all in at this point in time, though, and he's sending the disintegrator squads out. It's kind of like the position in the last game. He still has the nerve center. He just sold it off. He's only got one portal, though. He's sending everything he has at Bycrush's base. And what can Bycrush do against this? He's building buggies. It's really the only thing he can do at the moment. The bikes are moving through to the base here. Really, the disintegrator squads are going to just completely rip them to shreds. And Bycrush not moving through. He's actually trying to focus down the portal. And I think he knows if he gets the portal, that's the last production structure. He doesn't actually need to kill the harvester at this point in time, because when they're dead, that's pretty much it. And these buggies trying to focus down the disintegrator squads. Now, does he have a heroic one? No, he doesn't have a heroic one here. There's a lot of buggies. Here comes the kiting. And he's got nowhere near the amount of disintegrator squads he had last time. Bycrush not even going to micro back here. Is he going to be able to kill these guys off? Yes, I think he's going to have those guys down. And I think that might be the end of the line for Masterleaf there. And unfortunately, that all in rush game not going in his favor indeed. Game number 5 is going to go to Bycrush Owns. So Byte manages to take him down this time. Crazy Reckoner strategies there. Loses his Black Hand squad and puts Cabals inside. So that's pretty crazy. You don't see those in Reckoners very often. And look at that, another 5-minute game. So crazy short, but crazy intense. It's intense, I think, because, again, the atmosphere around these games and just what's happening in these games as well, and the craziness. We had $15,000 from Leaf, $15,500 from Bike, certainly $500 in it. Kill death ratio goes in Masterleaf's favor again with the disintegrators there, but again, probably needed to defend a little bit better in that game, and he would have been okay, but unfortunately not to be. He lost all the disintegrators straight away as well, which is a real pain for him. 5 minutes, 3 seconds. What can I say about that game? All in rush, very tense, very on edge, a lot of killing, really quick. And that's going to give Bycrush a 3-2 victory. So it's or a 3-2 lead, sorry. So it's going to come down to the next game here, which is going to be game number 6. This could be it for Leaf. He could be out of the tournament, going to third place, while Bycrush could be securing a spot in the grand final. What's going to happen? You'll have to stay tuned. Game number 6 is coming right up. All right, what's going on, everyone? It's Green Zero back here. We're in game number 6 of the preliminary finals, BE Kane's Wrath World Championship. You know the drill. It's going to be Masterleaf playing as Travel59 against Bycrush's Nod. Now, it looks like Leaf has used the single strike faction rule in this one here. I'm pretty sure he did as well. Didn't want to have to face Black Hand again. So he's up against Bycrush's Nod. And we're on tournament decision. Leaf got to pick the map. Obviously, wants to pick a bit of a closed map. You know, he doesn't want those big wide open spaces for that bike buggy. And you can't blame him. Bycrush, we'll have to see what he's going to do here. Obviously, he called Bycrush for a reason. Let's see if he's going to do it again. But he's gone for some... I mean, he's Vanilla Nod, so his scouts just aren't as good, especially if they're running over Tiberium. That's probably going to kill off one of the members of the squad, and it will just make it weaker. No members die, so it's still got its full firepower. But, I mean, it doesn't really matter about its health, because the Buzzer's insta-kill it anyway. Buzzer's doing sniper damage, by the way, in case you didn't know, but it's melee sniper damage. And Leaf is going to be going for two of these engineers or two assimilators. He's going to be moving these buzzers out across the map. This is going to be interesting. It's going to be 4 buzzer squads against 2, 3, 4 militant squads. So Bycrush has got plenty of the tank. He does garrison up the building, and then he decides to bypass these guys here. He's going to lose 1 buzzer squad, but I think he's fine with that. And he's going to run to the enemy spike and move up here. He's going to find no engineer. There is no engineer down here. Bycrush's engineer is actually in the center here. And isn't that annoying when they do that? They put the buzzer behind the spike and put it on whole ground stance. And then they just wait for the engineer. It just delays. And really, Masterleaf needs all the delaying he can get. I think Bycrush now, he's got a buggy, and it's going to, should be able to cut off this scout. Yeah, he's going to be able to cut off this scout. So Masterleaf can see a little bit into this base, not too far. He's going to secure both of his spikes just fine. That's not going to be a problem. We got our militant squad coming down into Masterleaf's main base here. He's going for a second ref, and a second war factory comes down now, and he's going to have to put down a second power plant if he wants to sell up. And again, the buggy does kill the buzzer swarm, but this has delayed Bycrush significantly. You know, if you think about it, it's probably delayed him a good 30 seconds. You know, that's 300 credit, and of course the $500 he spent on this, he's only just got back now. So that's not good at all for Bycrush, getting slowed down by Masterleaf. Masterleaf needs all the advantage he can get, because if he loses this game, he is out of the tournament. He's building Seeker tanks now, so maybe he sniffs something. I'm not sure if he knows what's up. But Engineer is now coming out from Bycrush. Oh, actually, no, he sold his MCV, sorry. So he has sold his MCV. I wonder what the Engineer is going to be going for. He could go for a tower, but if he's really going to rush, he might as well try to go for a spike, get himself some more eco. It's a long way for that unit to run. He could send it around the other side. There is a Buzzer Swarm inside this bunker, but it's definitely defeatable with a few scouts, which he does have position one here, and of course there's one inside the bunker as well. But again, he's moving some bikes around here. The engineer is running right down the guts, and Masterleaf, he is actually sending a Seeker tank away from his base. He's got 5 Seeker tanks at home. He's actually going to build a 6. Now, Bycrush can see this, and he's like, whoa, hang on a second. There are a lot more Seeker tanks here than I thought. He actually loses his buggy, which is more damage he can't afford to lose. Seeker tank is moving through now. It's getting shot up. You can see there's some bike buggy, but it's not too much. He kills the engineer, though. That's important. That's demoralizing for Bike Rush to lose that, because it's something he wouldn't expect to lose or wouldn't be expecting to lose. Bike's now positioned up here. Leaf has a gap open here. He needs to realize that maybe there's some units there, but of course he doesn't have eyes there. He's got a lot of Seeker tanks, though. He's got three, four, five, six, seven. He's got eight Seeker tanks, so eight Seeker tanks. And the bike's either going to go down there. They're not going to go down there. These Seeker tanks hurting around. Bike does go down over here. And this is nice because Bike Crush, because Master Leaf now, actually, you think normally it'd be overcompensating, but against Bike Rush, it's just not. He's got 3 and 2, so his economy isn't particularly strong. And here comes the attack. The Seeker tanks from over here going to pull forward to enforce. Two Seeker tanks go down. Or was that just one? I can't see. There's so much destruction and fire. Now they're going to engage, and Master Leaf is going to try to focus these guys down. He's got a general attack, so he's spraying the front line, causing as much damage as possible. A lot of these buggies are going to go down. That's good news for him, of course. The buggies are the tankers of the force, and the bikes, the damage deals. The bikes don't have the armor. He is going to snipe one harvester. He's going to pay for it with most of his bikes, though. And a lot of the buggies actually getting destroyed. A lot of gun-type weapon here. The Militant Squad's getting in on the action as well, drawing fire, doing random sporadic damage to Seeker tanks, and actually destroying some of them as well. But they will be cleaned up now. And Master Leaf does push that out of his base. He only loses one harvester, but he's on just two harvesters. I could imagine that Bike Rush is actually on two harvesters as well. Third harvester comes out now. Bike Rush is on two harvesters, and he brings his bike buggy back to base. They don't really need repairs, to be honest. These guys are pretty much in really good health, and he realizes it now. Turns around. He's got to get back on the offensive because, of course, Decision is a really easy map to defend rushes. I'm not saying it's not possible and stuff like that. I'm just saying it's better equipped for you to defend against these rushes. And he's going for a portal. Is he going for tier 1.5? He might be going for a stasis chamber, but he has 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. He's got 8 Seeker tanks, if I counted correctly there. They're moving around pretty quickly. He's going for disintegrator scores as well. So the Seeker tanks have done their job. They held the line. There are some bikes over here as well. Didn't even notice, and they're blending in with the side of the map there. Another Seeker tank comes out to spot. Now, this is important. He's trying to see, is bike still all in, or is he building an MCV? That's what he wants to know. If he's building MCV, he knows he's okay to keep ecoing. But Master Leaf now has 4 harvesters. He's got a big chunk of disintegrator Seeker tank here, which is going to be hard to get rid of. And Fastlegs is on its way, almost done, in fact. Master Leaf might be losing one of his spikes, though, so that would be a bit of a pain. Just that little bit of extra economy. And everything counts in these pro games at this end level here. That's really important to keep hold of these spikes. You know, that's advantages you can't be throwing away. In a casual game, you might not think of it too much, but this high-stakes tournament, that's really something you don't want to be losing. Leaf does not make an attempt to save it. You can't blame him trying to get out of his base. He'd be risk losing these Seeker tanks here if he just sends them. He's trading these Seeker tanks for disintegrator squads, and the buggies are probably just going to stay here and destroy them. One buggy goes down. What's happening over here? Oh, buggies try to roll and get decimated. 3 buggies immediately get destroyed. The disintegrators are all dead, but the buggies, the bikes were waiting back here, and now, of course, it's too late. The disintegrator squads know what's up, and wow. He got a lot of disintegrators. He's got triple portal. That's why he got them so fast. And this is important now. Bike Rush is going to come down here. There's not that much defending. You can probably overwhelm it, but I think he might pay. The price he pays for this might be a little bit too heavy, because look at Leaf's army in the middle. It's pretty big. And now he's just streaming units across. A few bikes make it through, but there's just more Seeker tanks there. And the disintegrator squads, and their Bike Rush is down. He doesn't even try to fight that. You can see in the middle of the map that line of just mass Seeker descent moving to his base, and there's nothing there to stop it at all. So Leaf had a perfect read on that game, and we were very happy with the way he played that, because in other games you see before, he just didn't realize what was going on. In that game, he knew exactly what was going on. Bike Rush obviously got a little bit predictable there, but nice hold from Leaf, knew what to do, when to do it, only lost a single harvester, I believe, and then turned around, did that push, and Bike Rush was never going to be able to hold that off, so he had to throw it in. But again, 6 minutes, 17 seconds, 26,000 to Bike Rush, 38,000 to Master Leaf. So you got an extra 12,000, which is important, especially in such a short game. That's definitely a nice lead that he'd be enjoying there. The Disintegrator Squad favorite unit, obviously Raider Buggy for Bike Rush. Again, you force more Raider Buggies out of Black Hand. That's good, because Raider Buggies don't exactly kill harvesters or really anything, except, you know, a Disintegrator Squad is when they're in force. But they're huge, huge tankers. They can tank a lot of damage, and they're just a real pain, and they're really cheap. $500, the cheapest vehicle in the game, those things are. But anyway, that's going to level the series 3-3. So the next game is the final game. Whoever wins goes into the grand final. Whoever loses is in the third place playoff. And really, at this point in the stream, it was just insane. Like, a lot of people saying that, you know, trying to go for Leaf, but at the same time, Bike Rush just not looking defeatable. and people saying this and that. But again, it was a great tournament, great atmosphere. We're going to head into the final game and see exactly what happens in the final game. It's pretty crazy. I'm Green Zero. Stick around. Game number 7 is coming right up. All right, guys, here we are, the deciding game. Winner goes to the grand final. It's Bike Rush Owns versus Master Leaf. And look at the map. We're on Mountain Pass. I don't think it's been played before in the tournament. I can't recall seeing it. But Bike Rush got to choose this, and he used his strike rule as well. So just putting Leaf in a really precarious position because Leaf can't play any of his Scrim factions now. He's on a map that I don't believe he really has played on. He may not even played on this map at all. And Bike Rush, I think that's why he chose it. He chose this map because he knows Leaf doesn't know how to play this map, and Bike Rush kind of does. He has played on it before. And we were all nervous. Everyone in the stream is very nervous. What's going to happen? How's it going to go down? GDI versus Black Hand. That's right. Master Leaf decided he was going to choose GDI in this faction, or this factional matchup here. Bike Rush will be playing as Black Hand. We're jumping in. This is it. The winner goes to the grand final and fights for $700. The loser is out of the tournament, going to third place and picking up just $50 here. Leaf is down here, fighting to stay in this tournament. Now he finished second in his group of 24, and he's been fighting since the elimination finals. Had a really tough time. He had to fight Excess Illusion, a best of 5 there. Took it to all the games. Then he had to face off against myself. He managed to beat me 3-1, and now he's in here with Bike Rush, 3-3. Master Leaf, Blue GDI, going to take both of his spikes. Heading out now. Let's check out what Bike Rush is doing. He's going to be able to take one of his spikes up here, and the other spike is going to be down to the south. Where is it? There it is. Trying to find out where it is. He doesn't have a second engineer. He only went for one spike. Okay, that's interesting. Just one spike for Bike Rush there. So that's definitely interesting. So I'm not sure what he's planning to do on this this level here, keeping it a bit in the dark at the moment, but we have Master Leaf down here. Again, he's just playing it safe. He's going to go for his War Factory. He is going to get his second spike. There is a Cabal squad here, but it's just not going to be there in time. Battle Marker's down there. Leaf loses a squad. Unfortunate, needs to get a scout off if possible, because he doesn't want to get rushed. Again, Mountain Pass, I was a bit iffy about it at first, but now that I've seen it played on a little bit more, I'm starting to warm up to the map. I mean, the center of the map is really a focal point here, but it's definitely open and wide. But at the same time, you've got these mountain choke points. And for a mountainous map, which has a lot of terrain, I think it could be rather popular if it's played on a bit more. I mean, it's definitely a map you could see people playing on a lot more. And I think we might have to include it as a base map in tournaments where you have to play on it in a certain round. But Master Leaf has 3 harvesters, 2 ref, and he is going for expansion. But Bike Rush has sold up his war factory, his Conyard, and a double war factory, placing the war factory in the corner, trying to keep it hidden as well. And a pit bull comes in, and that's all Leaf needs. He can see, hey, no second, where's your MCV? You've only got one ref. That can really only mean, I mean, it could mean that he is doing a fast expand, some kind of flame followed into bikes, and a few other things. But it's Bike Rush, and he redeploys. He's redeployed immediately. Predator tanks are on the build. He's building Predator tanks. He's like, all right, I'm not going to stand for this. I'm going to get the Predator tanks, which is really what he needs to build if he goes for pit bulls. They won't have the durability later on in the game. They can get sniped down in the early game, but Predator tanks are impossible for the Black Hand player to remove. And of course, later on in the game when they build up, he could actually take the other Garrison Ball there. I'm pretty sure that is Garrison Ball. Yeah, it definitely is, but not going to be able to take it down. Biker's actually focusing it down as well. I guess maybe just so Leaf can't garrison it in future. Taking it down now. Buggy is moving forward. And these Pred tanks, there's 3 Pred tanks here. Now the Buggy is going to move around the outskirts of this base. Is he going to knock down any more trees? Yeah, he knocks down a few more trees. It's funny how the Buggy, that flimsy, is knocking down these trees. So probably like wrap himself around one of those. Leaf tries to dig a foxhole. This is good because he gets vision on both of these entrances here and here to his base. Battle Marker's there. One bike gets picked off. Tries to go through the middle here, and Bike Rush is going to move around on this fancy ledge over here as well. Leaf can see this ledge because the spike gives him just enough vision to see this pass area, so he does know it's there. He might not be able to spot the bikes themselves though. And he gets the engineer as well. Engineer trying to steal his spike. That's interesting that Bike Rush didn't go for the vacant spike. They would have given him $500 straight away, and that Buggy is as good as dead. That Predator tank finishes him off. Nice. There's actually water on this map. Okay, I didn't notice that. I wonder if that's up the top as well. It is up the top. There's wind water on this map, and I guess it's not really that important. But nonetheless, there are now, there's 3 Preds. I'm pretty sure there's more than that. There's 2 Preds over here. APMO is on the research now, and these bikes really can't do much. Bike just waiting for an opportunity to come in, but I don't think it's going to happen. You can actually drive down there as well. That's pretty fancy. Not sure why you'd use that, but you know, it's one of those little things that makes the map look nice and could be utilized at some point. Trying to destroy this spike here, but again, he has rebuilt the MCV, and it's at this point that Master Leaf does do a scan, money scan, realizes, hang on a sec, Bike Rush is not... is not all in at this point anymore. He has rebuilt MCV and Leaf just a perfect read as well. Three harvests, he's got 5-2 on his main. He's going for APM, it's almost done. He's going for hammerheads. He's moving these predator tanks up here. They will clear away this area and save the bikes. They'll save the harvesters. But again, these bikes just can't do anything. They're just waiting for an opportunity that's never gonna come. And the pred tanks are actually moving away from this base, so there are a few bikes moving in here now. V35 comes in, he sells off the comm center, but he uses the trick where he doesn't garrison the rifleman squad inside, and he gets to use it as a scout. It's not the exploit, so it is a destructible one. Again, there is no exploiting, so if he did the V35 indestructible V35 exploit, then he would be punished for that, but he's not going to be punished. And it's going to be flame units here for Bike Rush, and he is going for the expand as well. We've got a battle marker over here. This harvester is going to get snipe out, so these bikes are actually going to pay for themselves now. They are going to get a kill on this this harvester. They blow one of their own bikes up, which is never, never good at all. And he's going to move through it in space. There is an APC there, and these APCs with APM, and the hammers should be able to clean it up just nicely. The V35 does get a scout off. See, there's only one ref there, and he knows that Bike Rush has expanded. But again, moving out with the hammerheads will be invaluable with the terrain here. They can really get a pretty good read and lock down these areas. Needs to keep the infantry levels down as well. Master Leech is pushing forward here. Again, very tense in this game. Very tense at all times here, because the loser is out, and you can feel it in both the players here. Bike Rush doing his best here to play traditional Bike Rush and just do crazy or never die strategies. Master Leech, on the other hand, isn't actually making that much progress. He's still got a standing army. His expansion isn't looking too healthy. And these hammerheads are going to be moving over here to this side of the map. Again, flying up and over those mountains. Again, very mobile here on this map. There is a SAM turret there. And he's going to have to be careful, because he's going to take fire now. And he's probably going to lose a hammerhead. No, he doesn't lose a hammerhead. He should probably pull that one back to base, because his health is non-existent. Quickly focuses down those infantry units. But he's going to lose one hammerhead. He might even lose another hammerhead. Another rocket volley goes off. Oh, that's going to kill one more hammerhead. That's unfortunate for Master Leaf here. That's $1,500 each. Now, these are units you can't throw away lightly. Battle marker over there. A few bikes come through. It's only two. It's not going to be enough to do any damage to Leaf. And Leaf has units over here. And he's just like, I don't even care. Blow those guys up straight away. I don't need them. I don't want those in my base. Battle marker over here, but it's just guys stepping on Tiberium. But again, Bike Rush, he's establishing himself. He's got double ref. He's establishing himself at the moment. And again, Bike Rush just seems to be able to recover from the most irrecoverable situations. I'm not saying he was in an irrecoverable situation, but he just seems to build up so rapidly. And this entrance to the base is going to be very important here. Hammerhead's flying over. That is the funky view there, as you can see them moving from that side of that, because we can rotate full 3D, of course. The Hammerhead's now moving through. It's like, nope, that's not going to be a good way to go. He might pay for it, in fact. Yeah, he's going to pay for it. One Hammerhead gets shot down. Two more very heavily damaged. Again, $1,500 a pop. He needs to make sure they get repaired. Even putting rifleman squads in them just makes them ridiculously powerful against infantry. I mean, you think they're powerful when they don't have garrisons. You put a rifleman squad in those things and they're crazy. But Leaf, realizing this area is a little bit too heavily defended, is going to move over here now. Bike Rush moving around the mountain. He's got a shorter path, but the infantry, of course, are slower. And that's going to allow Master Leaf to flank this base here. He's going to be moving in. He's going to focus down the SAM turrets. But really, is he going to be able to attack in this area? I don't think so, no. He's going to pull back. He's pulling back now into the center of the map. He's got good map control. He's got Bike Rush boxed in. Bike Rush doesn't really have... I mean, this infantry is basically his army. He's got nothing else aside from these infantry units here. And Master Leaf is actually going to come back in. He's going to poke his head in. He's like, all right, what's going on here? The hammerheads are rocked up now as well, but the sand turrets are respawning. He needs to destroy them straight away. Most of them gets destroyed pretty quickly, and he's going to move the hammerheads over. They are spread out, so they're not going to take too much splashdown from the rockets, but the predator tank's crushing, the APC's killing, and the hammerheads on top. It's going to thin the infantry army quite a bit, and Bike Rush is forcing to be sell up quite a bit, but again, he's just winning through attrition. He's just causing damage, random sporadic damage to the attacking forces and just wearing them down slowly. And yeah, Bike Rush has lost basically almost all of his units here, but again, he's not going to die of this attack. One hammerhead is actually going to make his escape over there as well, moving across the field here, forcing these harvesters off the line. Bike Rush is probably not too fussed about that. He might be able to get a harvest kill. No, these shredder turrets, just with the supercharged particle, you just can't sit there and tank that for too long. Pred tanks will probably be fine. The APC is going to take damage reasonably quickly, and then Master is like, all right, that's it, I might have to bug out there. He's actually backing up now. He will save a decent amount of these forces. I mean, not a decent amount, but, you know, three APCs, two Preds, unless that APC wasn't there. These guys reverse moving around the wrong side of town. That will probably cost them their lives there. And there is an Orca Strike coming in as well. Again, mainly used for scouting. Going to use it on this refinery. Not going to get anything, but it gives Leaf even more vision. So he's got more time to respond to what Bike Rush is doing. Meanwhile, what has Leaf been doing? He's got a Reclamator Hub out. A few solo structures here. He's building Juggernauts. The second Jug. Yeah, this is the second Juggernaut. MCV only just being packed up now. He's almost out of tip. He's only got 4 harvesters on this base here. In fact, there's only 5 harvesters in total, so he's done it very low on economy here. He's got 2 harvesters on the blue field, but he's rallied them there, hasn't realized they're there. And this force now is getting cleaned up. The APCs, it's just not enough APCs, and they are getting cleaned up. They do a decent amount of damage. I'm not sure if it's a nice enough damage for him, but nonetheless, damage. And he is actually harvesting now, so again, it was only momentary lapse there for Masterleaf on the blue tip, so we'll have to see how that goes. He's moving around these mountain areas again. Lots of bits of mountain peaks and all things like that. But again, you never feel constricted on the map at all. 3 Juggernauts out now. Let's see if he's actually cancelled that one there. Would have thought maybe he'd sold off the War Factory. He's got a couple of Riflemen Squad there. Could be garrisoning up these Hammerheads. He is rebuilding a few of these Hammerheads. Again, just checking out the blue field. Bike Rush not being able to get the blue field. So that's good for Masterleaf and Bike Rush again. Just trying to actually, did he one-clicked him? Yes, he did. He one-clicked him and he got 2 Harvesters, 1 Ref. And he quickly sold off the one-click plant, but now he has got a Redeemer out. And Bike Rush just doing what Bike Rush does best. And he's going to put, double Engineer inside that Wreck Redeemer, I think. And meanwhile, what's Masterleaf going to do about this? Is he moving out? He is moving out now. I'm not sure why he always force fires the ground everywhere he goes. He likes to bunch his forces up like that. Marv is out, triple rail. There is 1 hard point still remaining. And the Hammerheads spot the Redeemer. They're like, all right, maybe not that way, guys. And is he going to move the Marv forward? He doesn't have much anti-infantry, but there's not that much infantry here. There's only a small cluster. And I think even Bike Rush realizes it's probably not a good idea to go out just yet. He's got EMP buggies, though. Leaf could Marvis this field, but does he have time? Is MCV is in danger, actually? And the Marv realizes that Marv is going to try to cross the map, but it's got a significant distance to go before it gets there. And here come the EMP buggies now. Going to be able to EMP down. Oh, sniper teams. We've got sniper teams coming in. And they're going to come in and flank these guys from behind. Again, sniper teams not that great against Black Hand, obviously, because they take 2 shots to kill the actual Black Hand unit. And Regen goes off. One of the sniper teams gets killed. The Hammerheads turn around and fire at the Juggernauts, but it's not be enough. The Redeemer is taking artillery fire. One Sonic Mini gets dropped down, but unfortunately, the MCV goes down, and now these Hammerheads coming in trying to clean up the infantry squads here, and let's see how they do. And the Marv is chasing the Redeemer. The Redeemer tries to go up the ramp there, and I'm not sure if Bike Rush knows which way he's going. No, he tries to pull back to his base, and he's going to put himself in range of the Marv. The Juggernaut's firing on him now. Sniper teams are still here. There's still 2 squads by the looks of things EMPing down these harvesters, which appear to be full of blue tib, and again not refining that at all. But the Redeemer has its rear armor showing, and he's going to be heavy damage mode momentarily. He's heavy damage mode now. The sniper teams and the Hammerheads focusing down the infantry squads, and I think, yes, he loses the Redeemer. The Redeemer goes down now. So Bike Rush in a little bit of trouble here. He has got his MCV on the blue field. Meanwhile, these Juggernauts just chilling in the center of the map. The sniper teams are actually going to clean up the remainder of the infantry squads here very slowly, but surely they will kill them down. And the buggies have not really got much chance of killing those harvesters. I don't think Masterleaf is going to worry about trying to defend those at all against those buggies, and these Hammerheads really can't be affording to throw those away. And by the way, Masterleaf does not have a War Factory, which means he's just on airfield and racks tech, but he has all of his tech, so he can build all of his tech units from these buildings, but he can't recover his vehicles. So he's got no MCV. He's basically on just air and infantry aside from the units that he has at the moment, and he's calling in some support power. It's going to be Bloodhounds, so why not? It's the only thing he can really call in, the only vehicles he can get. He needs to build more Hammerheads. I feel if he has more Hammerheads, and at this point in the stream it was really tense because I think the game was drawing to a close at this point in time, and we were basically on edge. A Bike Rush is going to attempt to defend this one here. He has got a sniper team inside the Marv, and he is shelling down these forces here, suppressing Bike Rush and causing damage. There's no repairs for the Marv, by the way. The Marv cannot repair itself. He's got no way of doing that, no way of building a rig, can't build a War Factory. So every piece of damage that the Marv takes cannot be recovered. And the Hammerheads are going to be moving in here. The artillery doing so much damage, focusing down all the buildings from behind, and the infantry start to stack up a little bit, and the Juggernauts coming down and the splash. I mean, they're not terribly great at infantry, but when they stick up and they clump up all like that, they can suppress them and kill them pretty quickly. And look at that, Masterleaf actually comes through on this base here. He's moving through with his Marv now, and he's starting to waste Bike Rush's infrastructure. Bike Rush is going back for another Redeemer, and he's probably going to get it out in time as well, but these Juggernauts, and look at this, Masterleaf building Zone Troopers, because that's really, he can't really build much else. I mean, he could put them in the APCs, he could put them in the Hammerheads, that'd be great. He could even get Scanner Packs. He should still have a Command Center. It's only $500 for Scanner Packs. It gives him increased sight and increased attack range. I mean, anything to give him a heads up here. The Marv is veteran. He can Marvis the fields as well, but he is cleaning Bike Rush up here now. Bike Rush in a little bit of trouble. He still has 3 Juggernauts. He's got the Zone Troopers, and the Marv still has the majority of itself. Surprisingly, he took such little damage in that fight there. and now he's moving forward and he's killing the last of these infantry squads here. And Bike Rush needs to hold this off. He needs to hold this attack off, but really Leech doesn't really have anything else aside from this force here. And he's got a Redeemer Rage and that can be recycled endlessly. And a lot of the zone troopers getting torn up as well. There's a few squads left. Has he got anything else? He's got a few squads over here. Hammerhead's coming in. Needs to stay away from those SAM sites now. And does focus down another EMP buggy. But yeah, Bike Rush has got EMP buggies. He's going to make a stand. Here comes the EMP buggies. Master trying to focus it down. Of course, you can't reverse me while you're focusing buggies. And he gets them all. He gets every single EMP buggy. And now the Redeemer's in trouble. There's three Juggernauts firing at it. And rear armor does so much damage to the Redeemer. And he's moving forward. The Juggernaut's trying to fire on it. Bike Rush selling off his buildings now. He's in all sorts of trouble. The Hammerhead's coming around, thinning the rest of the infantry out. No more EMP buggies. They're just getting milled outside of the War Factory. And now the War Factory's under attack by the Marv and the Juggernauts. And that's going to be Bike Rush's production going down. He has nothing left at all. Absolutely nothing left. He's got a hand of nod, and that's it. The Redeemer is fighting the Marv, but the Marv still has more health than the Redeemer. And there's Juggernauts here. The Marv is in low health mode, but oh man, Bike Rush can't do much. He can't run. Where is he going to run to? He's only got three buildings left in the whole game. And Master Leaf comes through, and he is going to defeat Bike Rush. In the preliminary finals, Bike Rush is out of the tournament. And again, I recommend watching the stream because me and Cybert, we lost our shit in that game there. That was crazy when Leaf came through and won that game. We even spoke to Master Leaf on Skype afterwards and he couldn't believe it either. He was just, he was ecstatic with that game, how that game went. And we couldn't be more happy there. That was crazy. A 15 minute game. That was actually the longest game in the series. And they get a 15 minute game more, which you'd expect out of pro players here. 4.97 kill death ratio to Master Leaf. So you can see there at the end, he was just so much more cost effective. 0.16 to Bike Rush now. And again, even without a War Factory, again, just pulling zone troopers and hammerheads. And again, it was really tense. You know, from our perspective, halfway through that game, we didn't know if Leaf was going to win. You know, we thought, oh, he started out great. And in the middle, he was just slipping and slipping and slipping and continually slipped all the way. And then that last attack, it was basically do or die for Leaf. And he came through and didn't lose any of the Juggernauts. The Marv still stood, and that was the important part there. They could have gone down in that engagement had it gone a little bit differently, but he really committed to that fight, and he had to commit to the fight, and he made the decisions he needed to make. And Bike Rush will go down in that game. 123,000 to Master Leaf, only 107,000 to Bike Rush. So Master Leaf, they're getting about $16,000 more than him. It's a nice buffer for a 15-minute game, but it's not terribly serious. But nonetheless, we couldn't be happier there. I mean, not smack talking Bike Rush or anything like that, but it's nice to see Bike Rush not in the grand final. You know, the biggest games at tournament since Ladder Season 3, you know, which Bike Rush wasn't present for, you know, and he couldn't deliver the goods. I mean, it's as simple as that. Smaller no-name tournaments that attract very few players. Yeah, no worries, Bike Rush wins those, but unfortunately, when it came down to a high-stakes tournament, Bike Rush couldn't handle it. And Master Leaf, if you think back on that series, how clutch half that series was. And it was an insane series, and by the end of it, again in the stream, can't mention that enough, we just lost it. It was insane. And Master Leaf will be joining Unleashed UA in the grand final there. Unleashed going through to the grand final as well. Bike Rush Owens will take third position. The Cane's Wrath World Championships 2014. That's the preliminary finals number B. Master Leaf, crazy series. Crazy series. Master Leaf will be going through, and that will be played shortly after after I cast this one here. It'll be played later on today, actually. Because it is delayed because of the, obviously, Master Leaf's a bit fatigued from playing about 16 or 17 games in a row over a 6-hour period, so we decided to postpone another day. Unleashed was fine with that, but again, what more can I say about that series? Really, you should see this stream on Cybert's channel, because if you haven't, you know, that's really the best place to see it. I'm really casting it for more formality, again, if you just like to see the cast afterwards. But anyway, I'm Green Zero. That was your preliminary final. That was one of the best matches in the tournament there. Between Master Leaf and Bike Rush, the best series, should I say, knocking Bike Rush out of the World Championships 2014. Master Leaf is going through. Is he going to win the grand finals? Stay tuned to my channel, stay tuned to the stream, stay tuned to Cane's Wrath Online. That's your Cane's Wrath World Championships preliminary final at number B. I'm Green Zero, and I'll see you all at the grand final.